Are the stock market posting its best start to a new year since 2006? And with that, let's welcome back JJ Kinahan, Chief Market Strategist at TD Ameritrade. JJ, good to see you. Welcome back.
Always a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
So it's hard to describe the bullishness in words. I mean, this is coming after years and years and years of gains in the markets.
It is, and particularly last year, where gains were unlike anything we've seen for many, many years. And the momentum is really continuing as we start 2018, I think, which is a surprise to many of us. And with that, we're seeing people not sell off and taking profits to the level many of us thought they would.
So is it too late to put money to work in U.S. stocks? I think that's the big question that many retail investors are grappling with right now.
Well, I think if you look, we publish our IMX, and you and I talked about it, and that measures how our clients interact with the market. The one thing I would say that it showed this year is that our clients took a very gradual approach to getting into the market. Mm-hmm. So if you're someone who's saying, should I get in right now, I would say get in gradually. But if you want to buy, set a price level, buy something there. What you should be thinking about is, what will my average price level be where I want to buy if it falls? To me, that's more important than saying I'm going to buy here and expect it to immediately go up. Most people don't have the problem that they buy things and they immediately go up. So prepare for the downside and what your average price will be.
Well, and tech was a big winner in 2017. A lot of people wondering if that momentum will continue this year. What sectors should investors be focusing on in 2018?
I think that tech will continue to be a leader. I think financials will continue to be a leader, just as they both were last year. Housing is the most interesting area to me. And the reason I think housing is so interesting is we saw in the October housing report that more than 50% of the new homes sold hadn't even broken ground yet. Mm-hmm. The other thing I put that with, many people looked at last week's jobs report and saw a lot of bad. I thought it was actually a pretty good report. Yes, the retail jobs being lost were quite a surprise, but to put those back in, and it's not a bad report at all. And the thing I like, in three areas, you created careers, not jobs, and those areas being business-to-business services, construction, and manufacturing. Construction and manufacturing particularly have been on a run the last 6 months. There's confidence in your economy. There's people who are going to be looking for new jobs. So the housing sector, to me, is the most interesting one as we head the next year.
It's an important point you bring up, because even though we only had 148,000 jobs created, the three-month average is still above 200,000.
Yeah.
So that's great.
It's great. And we also saw wage pressure, Scott. 3/10% growth there met expectations. At some point, employment becomes a case of diminishing returns, where it's hard to create these new jobs. To your point, three-month average is good. So now they may have to start competing on wages, which the Fed would be very happy about from an inflationary point of view.
In terms of risks to the markets, obviously North Korea, but, some strategists are saying that a crash in Bitcoin prices could potentially spill over into the rest of the stock market. What do you make of an idea like that?
Well, I don't think Bitcoin is I think it's very interesting, and a lot of people may have some money in there, but I don't know that many people have a lot of their core holdings in there. Momentum-wise, yeah, it may hurt, but what actually scares me more is the buy-the-dip mentality has worked so well for the last few years. So we'll say we go down 2%, people come in to buy again. Now what if we go down 5% or even 8%? My fear is that those people who've been to buy the dippers, it works so well, and God bless them. If we get down 5% and it's not working, that they turn around and we see exponential sellers because they're selling what they've had before plus what they just bought. So the selling momentum could really gain quickly to the downside if we get down between 5 and 8%, in my opinion.
All right, so buy the dip cautiously, essentially.
Very, very cautious. I always say it's like playing football. If you run up the middle and it's working, you don't stop running up the middle if somebody stops it. So by the dip, people are in the same boat right now.
All right, JJ Kinahan, thank you as always for coming back.
Always a pleasure. Thanks.